do you want?
Well, one of you with my old friends. Sadie, I'm scared of the world out here. I don't know how it works and I'm too old to adjust to it. I just wish I'd never opened my mouth to Janice Grant and stayed happily inside Wentworth.
Meg, just a minute before you go, can I have a word? I wondered if I could stay at your place tonight.
Oh, yes, of course, but...
I've finally decided to move away from Norm, and, well, I haven't made any arrangements. Look, I'll explain later. It's just that I need a bed tonight. Will that be all right?
Yes, yes.
Thanks.
A certain associate of your husband are a little concerned as to what you might say to the authorities.
There's no need for concern. I have absolutely no intention of telling them anything.
Ah, well, you see, that's just the point. Your husband and these associates find that there is a small number of, shall we say, minor people for whom they have no further use. His instructions are that you reveal their names and any other information I pass on to you about them at irregular intervals. That should keep everybody happy, especially the police.
What's this all about? You look like you've won Tatch Lotto or something.
Oh, better than that. Much better. I'm going back to Wentworth.
What?
I'm going back the only way possible. I'm going to commit a crime. They'll have to take me back then, won't they?
Out here all alone, look after yourselves.
I'm here now.
We'll all be back to normal, I promise.
She seems to have brightened up a little.
Just what she needs, the garden to think about. She'll be her old self in a couple of days.
Oh, look what I found.
What is it, love?
Oh, look at the back of the geranium, see?
Oh, I see it. Isn't it lovely?
Oh, if I can get it out without hurting it, I'm going to put it in a pot and I'm going to bring it inside.
Oh,
it must be pretty strong to last it out here.
Lovely, isn't it?
I had some wool just that colour once.
I used to know the Latin name for geranium.
Oh, don't start going all foreign on me again.
Oh, really? I'd hardly call knowing the botanic appellation of the geranium going foreign.
You want to watch it digging around in there. You might find more than you've bargained on.
What?
Time to time round here. People don't toe the line, have accidents. What's left of them has to get put somewhere. All makes for good fertiliser, though, eh? You want to watch what I tell you, or you might wind up in there yourself.
Sorry, you shouldn't leave your weeds lying around where people can walk on them.
Bugger.
I know. You could hold up a garage.
What's wrong with a bank? Not the one where I've got my money, mind you. You can't be accused of stealing your own money, can you?
But bank robbers always get caught.
That's the idea.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Honestly, you can't keep your mind on one thing for more than 10 seconds. No, I definitely think it's got to be a bank.
Have you got a gun?
Of course I haven't got a gun. What have I got for?
Well, why else are they going to hand over the money?
I don't want them to hand over the money. I just want them to think that I want them to hand over the money. Oh, it's the truth. It was a perfectly good idea till you got involved in it. There must be something simple I can do. Got inside easy enough last time. Oh, it's the truth. Talk about opportunity staring you in the face.
Yeti! Wait! Don't! You can't drive!
Truck, just just a wireless. Get out of the way.
Hey!
I did it. I confess. Take me away. I'm not fit to be in decent society.
You better watch it, love. You'll do yourself an injury running around like that.
What do you think you were doing?
I can't help myself. When the urge comes upon me, I pitch anything I can lay my hands on. Jail's the only place for the likes of me.
You've been hitting the bottle, lady.
Silly old sausage. She'll do anything for a bit of a laugh.
You gonna call the police?
Oh, you're wasting your breath.
I'm a criminal. I know my rights. You gotta call the police.
Well, I'm moving Malone from maternity to H block, so that should solve at least some of your staffing problems.
Well, let's hope that puts a smile on Joyce's face. I think she and Norm have had a row.
Good heavens, that must be a first. Nothing serious.
Oh, I'm sure it'll blow over.
I hope so. I'll be leaving a bit early today.
Right.
Pippa's coming home from London.
That's terrific. How long's she been away now?
About 2 years.
She still want to be a designer?
She doesn't want to be, she is. She graduated a couple of months ago and she's already got an assignment. She'll only be here for a couple of weeks' holiday and then she's off to Japan.
Do you ever wonder if we're in the right job?
She's always been interested in the glamorous life. I still think of her as my little girl, of course, but can't wait to see how she's changed.
Dad!
Leave me alone. We've got something for you.
We found another one right in at the back.
Oh, it's gorgeous. Oh, I haven't got anything to trade for it.
Oh,
I'm sure you could find some little thing, dear.
Oh, now, how typical. It's not a trade, it's a present.
It's from both of us.
Oh, it's the nicest thing anyone's ever gave me. Oh, hello, I'm Daphne. Your geranium, my bericum. I'm going to call you Jerry Bat.
Come on, why don't we go and have tea and let Jerry settle in, eh?
Okay. Look at him, he's beautiful, isn't he? Oh, I bet you thought I was going on like a sport kid, didn't you? It's just that I got so upset when I saw that other poor thing just lying there broken and crushed like that.
It was a tragedy.
Well, come on, let's tidy up and then we'll go and have tea.
Okay. Oh, Annie Mae, I can't leave him here alone because Lou might come and get him.
No, she won't. I've told her what'll happen to her if she tries that trick again.
I thought I'd be out of here by now.
Not according to the book. The governor says that's how things are going to be run around here from now on. Outside. Good to see you, Desmond. I was beginning to think I'd never have that pleasure again.
You'd be a fool to try anything.
Good friend of yours came to visit me.
Mrs. Reynolds will be watching every move you make.
Sister Selby. Passed on your kind regards. Interesting woman, Sister Selby. Gave me a lot to think about.
Is that so?
Made me understand that it's hard work being a Christian. You know, having to forgive and forget. Wouldn't you agree, Desmond? Turning the other cheek? Yeah, hard work. But she seemed convinced that it was all worth the effort in the long run. Maybe I should try it.
If you have something to say, Miss Ferguson...
Patience, Desmond, patience. It's a virtue, isn't it? I don't know what I could have been thinking of. Mad impulse, that's what it was.
Oh, you don't have to go making up excuses. Everyone thought you were just having a joke.
All I'm saying is, if I'd thought it through properly, I would have pinned something that was worthwhile. I wouldn't have thought it was so damn funny.
But you did look pretty silly, though. I confess. Take me away.
You show a bit of respect, Sadie Grimshaw. I've been among some pretty hard people in my time, and I've always held my own.
Well, the trouble is, these days, there are more criminals than police. They can't keep up.
Just the other month, my daughter Cassie and her husband were burgled. They'll never find him.
Yeah, of course. Why didn't I think of that?
Oh, good girl. You aren't as silly as you look.
What'd I say?
Don't you see? I'll take the credit for what somebody else has already done. I'll confess to a crime I didn't commit.
And question 10. Who invented television? What was your answer, Kelly?
Curry Jack.
Eh?
Get it? Telly Savalas.
Oh, I thought he invented lollipops.
Oh, no.
Well, the answer's John Logie Baird.
Oh.
Will anybody get it right?
No.
You, me.
Oh, well done. Well, everybody, now count up how many you got right. Did anybody get them all right?
No.
Well, one wrong. Two wrong. Three.
Yeah.
You only got three wrong?
Yeah.
Well done, Patterson. You can be proud of that. Four wrong. Five?
I got five.
Good. Well, how many got four right?
Me.
Oh, why don't you tell him? You've got three. The same as me.
I didn't. I got a lot wrong.
Two.
Boom. I only got them right because I copied
one.
A few.
Mm. Will anybody get none?
Yeah, me.
Oh. Bill.
Yeah, all right. Come on, everybody. There's nothing to be ashamed of. We're all here to learn after all. Flynn, get a couple of pencils for me.
Mr. Crookshank, I've got something in my throat. Can I get a drink, please?
Yes, sure, dear. Well, all in all, I think everybody did really well. Yes, she did. Oh, some of those questions were quite tough.
Jeez, I'm quite glad you're back. Some really weird things have been going on
here.
Before
you know it, we'll
tell
you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's a walking encyclopedia.
Well, welcome back.
Thank you, Finn.
Thanks.
Oh, here. Oh, I like this one. A gun-toting granny still at large.
Let me see.
All I'm going to do is change my name. Say if I shot anyone, maybe I can get life.
Etty, that was 1975.
Oh. But it says she's still at large, though.
The magazine was 1975. Besides, it was in America.
People do move around, you know, especially wanted criminals.
What about this? In today's paper, a woman fraudulently cashed over $50,000 in pension checks. She's still at large. She's 65 and got red hair. There's a picture here. A bit fuzzy, though.
Oh, looks all right. Wait a minute. I haven't got red hair.
Well, we can soon change that, dear.
Well, I'm glad to hear nothing too drastic happened while I was in the pound. I'd like to know what that fight was between Callie and May, though.
No one knows except them. And I suppose Willie. She and May tell each other just about everything. But she won't say anything.
Yeah. How are you settling in, anyway?
Oh, all right. A bit different to Barnhurst. Still a prison. Hate it when the lights go out.
Look, you know what the grapevine's like in here. There's been a buzz about you trying to kill that baby at Barnhurst.
I didn't do it.
Now, come on. You know what happens in here to people who touch kids? It usually means trouble. Now, if there's trouble, I need to know all about it so I can help you. If I want to help you.
Okay, I'll tell you. Young mother at Barnhurst, Josie. Sweet kid, but very mixed up. She was trying to kill a baby. I managed to stop her. I ended up getting the blame for it. Worst thing was, while I was on the run, Josie did kill him. Do you think anyone came to me and said, "Sorry, we know now you're telling the truth"?
Yeah. Usually the way. How long were you on the run for?
3 months. Tried to get out lots of times before that, especially when I was first in. They thought I was a difficult prisoner, wouldn't toe the line. But they wore me down eventually. It's what these places are for, isn't it? Ended up feeling like a zombie. Empty. Gave up trying to get out.
But you did make another break for it. How come?
Suppose I just thought I'd paid my debt. I knew they'd never give me the parole. And if I waited much longer, it'd be too late.
Too late? What for?
No. Just too late, that's all.
Tell me more about the research you'll be doing in Japan.
It's for a British company, actually. They want me to do a series of neo-trad Japanese designs for one of their standby lines. God, I'm probably doing it for free, but at least I'm getting the trip out of it.
Well, it all sounds pretty exciting to me. Better than being stuck behind a desk at Wentworth.
Go on, Anne, you wouldn't swap that job for anything in the world.
Oh, there are times I'm not so sure. Still, I suppose I have my successes from time to time. Would you like to see over the place?
Oh, we'll have to see. I'm not here for long, and, oh, there's a lot of old friends to catch up with. Becky Willis, the Craig Wilsons, and, of course, Jenny.
Jenny Hartley? What's she doing now?
Oh, she's still studying music. I've had letters from her, but I'm afraid I've been a bit slack replying.
What about old Mrs. Hartley? She's still alive?
Is she ever?
Look, if you'd like to have your friends over here for a party, we could arrange
something. We'll have to see what pans out.
What about boyfriends? Anyone special yet?
Well, yeah, there is someone. It's pretty serious, but I doubt if you'll approve.
Why shouldn't I?
Well, for a start, he's older than I am.
Well, there's nothing very terrible about that.
He's also married with three kids. He still lives with them, but we see each other every day.
Pippa, how could you? I really thought you'd have more sense than that. Are you serious?
Yes, and I'm well and truly old enough not to listen to advice I don't want. In the interest of keeping this trip a pleasant one for both of us, let's just stay off the subject, okay?
Everybody decent?
Not according to the paperwork. What is it?
Safe to come in, Mr. Cruikshank.
Well, hurry up, Patterson. You're due on kitchen duty 10 minutes ago. Come on.
Just
quick,
go on,
quick.
Mr. C.
What's the matter, Flynn? Lost something?
No, Mr. Cruikshank. I think I've got to go in there.
Oh, sure. Hurry up, Myra.
Look a bit pale. Are you okay?
Yeah. Funny tummy. Always had it.
I'll leave you to it.
I'm not sure whether Pippa's changed or whether I'm just realising how little we really know each other. Perhaps the only thing we have in common is that we both loved her father so much. Since he died, we just don't have much to say to each other.
Well, it's the same with me and Marty. I think the main thing is just to talk to her as a friend. I mean, when kids get to that age, they like to think they don't need their mothers anymore.
Yes, I suspect you're right. Well, I'd better get back to the bridge. Got a couple of heavy guns from the federal police coming to see me about the Ballinger woman. Probably want to know why I haven't arranged a serviced room with a heated swimming pool and an ocean view for her.
I've got a real good job for you this morning. I want you girls to ice this cake for me. Do you know how to mix up the icing?
No. You can tell us, Bert.
Well, all the ingredients are there, and it's written down there how to mix them. It's important to get everything in the right proportions.
Oh, Dev's good at that, aren't you, Dev?
Oh, well, if it's written down, yeah.
All right, ask me if you're not sure.
Now, it says here that we need 2 teaspoons of vanilla essence. Okay. Essence? Oh, we need another teaspoon.
What for?
Well, it says here 2 teaspoons, see?
Look, you only use one to measure it out, Dev.
But it says 2.
Look, you use the same one twice. Come on, get on with it. I'll be here all day. Oh, hang on, you've got to put the icing sugar in first. Oh, jeez! Dev, you're useless!
Sorry. Sorry.
I understand your difficulties. But Arnie Ballinger wouldn't set foot in this country if his life depended on it. His wife is the next best thing. If she gives us a fraction of what she knows, we could virtually wipe out his organisation.
There must be ways of dealing with her other than treating her like royalty. I've got other
she
women to consider.
She holds as many cards as we do, and we can't keep her long. We have to go along with whatever she wants.
You're making a mockery of the penal system and putting me in a completely impossible situation.
Yeah, well, what about those kids who end up dead at 18? They get put in impossible situations, too, by people like Ballinger.
Have you any idea of how many drug-related deaths are in this country every year? Have you seen the statistics?
Of course I've
Look,
seen the
Look, we've got
statistics.
To stop him. And I don't care how we do it.
By lowering ourselves to their level.
I'm afraid in this game, it's the only level. We don't like it, but it's the way it is.
How many years did I work for your father? How many years?
And never once did the law come within sniffing distance of either of us.
Blind luck. Sheer blind, stupid luck.
You watch how you speak about your father. He was infinitely cleverer than you'll ever be.
Talking about him, you're the one who was stupid.
And look what happened when I associated with you.
I couldn't run the business honestly after he died. I only dealt with you out of sentiment. For Bull. The sake of Porter.
All you other customers left you in droves when you took over. I only stayed with you because I was sorry for you.
And I wouldn't be here if you hadn't.
Well, neither would I.
Oh, give it a rest, girls. Desmond here is not used to crowds. Have a nice little holiday.
I had time to think. Came up with a few ideas.
Why don't you tell us about them?
Not yet.
Oh, yeah, you're all mouth, Desmond. And everyone here knows it.
I said not yet, Kelly. But when the time comes, don't worry. You'll be the first to know.
Long time till Christmas, too.
And this is such a good idea.
Oh, go on. You'll get a real buzzing.
He's coming.
Belle, how's it coming on?
We finished. What do you reckon, eh, Merv?
That's completely tasteless and not least funny. Get rid of it.
What's the matter with you? Can't you take a joke?
How much of a laughing matter would it be if the joke were on you?
Told you you wouldn't like it. Well, if that's what love does to you, all I can say is I'm never getting mixed up in it.
It's not you we're after. Or your husband. We want the people who run the Australian end.
Particularly the business types and legal people.
What if I could give you all that? What would I get?
We could make it more comfortable in here for you.
Seems to me I've already been promised that. And I'm not very impressed with the results. Yesterday morning I asked for a telephone and was told it was out of the question.
Reckon we could do something about that. If it was worth our while.
Listen, gentlemen, from where I'm sitting, this is a seller's market. And it's starting to look like you can't meet the price. So you better decide how important my information is to you. While you've still got the chance.
You can't be serious. A private phone line in her cell.
Don't worry. It won't be your responsibility.
Everything
we'll arrange
that happens in this prison is my responsibility, whether I like it or not. I've already told her she can't have a phone. What do you think it does to my authority to have you coming in here overruling me?
As far as anyone need know, it's your decision.
I'll know it's not my decision, and so will Ballinger.
Whatever else she may be, she's not stupid. And she's certainly not the type to gloat about.
That is not the issue, and you know it.
This would be as much to our advantage as hers. We'll have a tap on the line. We could pick up some very useful information.
You've just told me yourself she's not stupid. She'll take it for granted the phone's bugged. She's not going to tell you anything she doesn't want you to know.
Maybe. But before long, she's going to be getting very lonely. I think that phone will have a lot of use. Sooner or later, she'll let something slip.
Apart from which, in return for the phone, she's agreed to give us some concrete information. To name some names.
But the
point
is,
Mrs. Reynolds, it's going to happen. And if you are not prepared to cooperate, I am prepared to talk to your superiors.
Well, obviously you'll do what you'll do. But I could still make it difficult for you.
It really would be better all round if you didn't try.
Up to you. I'm prepared reluctantly to cooperate. But there will be limitations.
Daphne?
Yeah? Oh, nothing's wrong, is it?
No, that's why I stopped you, to tell you what a good job you've done of cleaning my room again this morning.
Oh, that's all right. I like doing it.
There must be something I can give you in return.
No, honest. I like doing it. I really do. Look, I've got to get back to the kitchen. Mr. Crookshank told me not to be too
long. Oh, yes, Mr. Crookshank. He seems a decent type.
Yeah.
Is he as lily white as he makes up?
What?
I've always thought that people in that sort of position can be bought. It's just a matter of finding the right price.
Oh, I don't know. He's nice. Oh, that Miss Ferguson, though. You know, the things they say about her, nothing would surprise me.
What sort of things do they say?
Oh, just how mean she can get. She gives me the creeps. You know, she reminds me of one of them big, black, ugly caterpillars that go around eating flowers like they can't stand to see anything beautiful in the world.
Yeah, I suppose you could describe her like that. You like flowers, don't you?
Oh, yeah, more than anything. I reckon in a garden's the loveliest place you could ever want to be. I think I'd be happy if I could do nothing else in my life but plant flowers and look after them. I had a butte garden at Barnhurst. We had to leave that when I came here. Look, I gotta go because I saw Miss Ferguson before, and if she catches me here, I'm gonna be in real trouble, okay? See ya.
Wait. We certainly mustn't upset Miss Ferguson, must we?
I've just found out why you changed your shift. Why didn't you tell me the trial was today?
Because I knew you'd want to take time off and come with me.
Well, that's right, I would have.
Dennis, you've done more than enough to help me.
Oh, God, Meg, we're supposed to be friends. Come on. That bastard Mulhare is going to put up as strong a defence as that other bloody maniac.
Look, it won't be as bad this time. I know what to expect. And I'm determined that this man will get as long a sentence as Peter Wright did.
I think I should come with you. But Anna, understand
Dennis,
if I take
no.
the after...
I've got to do it myself.
Why?
I don't know. I just have to.
You got pluck. I'll say that for you. Come down and have a drink when you get back, eh?
Thanks, but I don't think I'll be in the mood.
All right. Well, if you change your mind, I'll be there.
Okay.
Help carry some of those at once. You'll break them.
Sorry, Mr. Pringle.
Oh, hello.
Could I see you for a minute?
Go on with your work.
What's the matter?
I've made up my mind. I'm moving out of the house. I can't stand it any longer. I just have to have a break.
I know it's a hard thing to decide, but it's probably for the best. It's nothing fancy, but if you want to stay at my place, you know you're welcome.
No, Mervyn. Thank you, but my moving out's got nothing to do with us. It's just that I have to get away from Norm for a while or I'll go mad.
Oh, I see. But you still need cheering up. Why don't you come over this evening and I'll cook you up something really special for dinner.
Oh, don't mean to interrupt or anything, but what do we do now, Mr. Pringle?
I don't know. Why don't you clean the stove? Do I have to tell you everything? I'm afraid they seem to know about us. Some of the women.
Know about us? But how could they? There's nothing for them to know, not really.
I know that.
We're just friends.
I know.
There's nothing wrong with that.
I know there's not, but you know what they're like. Anyway, what about it?
What?
Dinner tonight.
No, Mervyn. Thank you, but considering what's happened, that would really be quite out of the question.
Comics.
What condition?
Oh, like new.
They are not. They're all torn and ratty. I wouldn't use them for loo paper.
You make it a dozen, and I might think about it.
I don't believe it. All this fuss over a bottle of department store nail polish. Wait till you've been in here for a while. You'll believe it.
How about
you? Buy up goes on things you need. The only time you see that sort of stuff is when you get visitors who bring in presents. It doesn't happen very often. Even you might be surprised to see how quickly your friends drop you now that you're inside.
I don't care who your brother-in-law is, mate. If you can't provide proof that these good...
I tell you, I can't take it anymore. I can't. On the run day and night, held up like an animal by the avenging armies of law and order. I tell you, I can't take it. I surrender. Take me away. Lock me up. Banish me forever from the society of decent human beings.
Can I help you, madam?
Yeah, I told you. I've come to confess.
Oh, yeah? Just in general or to something in particular?
Oh, here, see that? That's me. I did it. No need for a trial or anything. Just lock me up.
Ron, take this lady to a seat, will you? Keep your eye on her. I'll take a statement from you just as soon as I finish with this gentleman.
Ah, that's the right lad. No hurry. Right, over here.
That's it.
Right,
now, you.
Well, Kelly.
What?
Oh, I just wondered where you got to. Haven't seen much of you since I came back.
Yeah, I missed you too.
Get rid of that.
What?
A cigarette, get rid of it. I don't like people smoking when I'm talking to them.
I'm on a break. I can smoke if I want it. Happy?
You know, Kelly, time lately to reflect on a few things. Like some of the things that Sister Selby used to say about good and evil. It all gets back to what I've always thought. Some people who are just born with nothing good about them, and they never change. Like you and Desmond. You must have wanted to get rid of me real bad to risk a frame-up like that. Still, well, it didn't work, did it? Now your life is going to get very rough.
Yeah? You lay one finger on me and I'll scream blue murder. They'll come down on you like a ton of bricks. They want you gone as bad as we do.
Is that right? Well, we'll just see, won't we?
Oh, it's all right. Come in. Miss Ferguson was just throwing her weight around. She hasn't found out yet. There's been a few changes since she went away. Nowadays, I got me some backup.
You know, if I were you three, I'd stop trying to play with the grown-ups and get back to work. While you still can.
You're to be permitted to have a phone in your cell as requested.
Yes.
If I were you, I wouldn't get too smug about it just yet.
Was I being smug? I'm sorry. Please forgive me. When will it be installed?
No idea. It has nothing at all to do with me.
I'm disappointed that you're taking this attitude. The fact that the department finds my comfort more important than your ego is
hardly... The privilege will be discontinued if you fail to observe the following condition. The phone will have a lock. You'll be supplied with a key. No other prisoner will be permitted to use it. If anyone's found doing so, you will be held responsible and I will personally see you punished with a spell in solitary. Is that understood?
Well, I'm curious to know what makes you think you can impose such conditions.
The fact that I'm in charge of this prison.
Here's a list of some of the things I still require, including some food. The stuff you serve in here is inedible.
You really expect me to let you have all this?
I'm sure you'll be kind enough to pass it on to your superiors. Was there anything else you wanted to talk to me about?
Is she going to chucky be back with the skip burner?
Someone probably said hello to her and she fainted.
I told her to take her time. Seems to me she needs to move around her own a bit more. Build up a bit of confidence.
Oh, that'd be right. Real tough bunch of friends you got these days, Desmond. You need muscle to stay on top, and I'm the one that's got it now. Even the freak's not going to take me on.
I wouldn't bet your life savings on that.
Nora, love, you don't look well.
I'm all right, just a bit lightheaded.
Listen, go over to the infirmary, make them give you something.
I'm all right. I'll just have a rest for a sec. You look awfully pale to me.
Well, one of these days I'm going to come in here and actually find someone working. Now get on with it.
Flynn is sick, she shouldn't be here.
I said get on with it. If this work isn't finished today, you'll all be on a charge for slacking.
Oh, come on. We've got an extra load to get through. What's the matter with the morning?
Because we're doing things by the book these days, Desmond. Or didn't anyone tell you? Then why bother telling you anything? Looks as though you're not going to be top dog for much longer. The way the competition's shaping up.
Catch her!
Oh, Lord, she's so sick.
Come on, Flynn, stop playing games.
She's not. Have a look at her. Now, she's got to get to the infirmary. Isn't that what your book says?
Right, take her. But don't think any of you are getting away with anything.
Hey, where are we going? This isn't the way to the cells.
No, it's the way out to the street. You're free to go.
Go? I don't want to go. I want to pay my debt to society.
You'll just be a good girl and stop wasting police time.
You've got to put me in jail. That's the law.
Lady, I've spent the last 2 hours checking out this story of yours. It's got holes in it a mile wide. Your fingerprints don't match Mrs. Ellery's, neither does your signature. And I have got a migraine. So would you please find someone else to annoy?
My body's a bit rusty, that's all. And what do you expect? Never had to write anything inside.
Inside?
Yeah, inside a POW camp. I was captured in Singapore. Oh, they kept me there for years till I finally escaped and returned to a life of crime. What's the matter with you anyway? Don't you know there's a war on? In the interest of national security, I demand that you lock me up.
Not gone in 2 seconds. I'm locking you up for public nuisance.
Oh, I suppose it'll have to do. How many years will I get?
One night. Just long enough for us to put you on file so we know who you are if you pull this caper again. Now, what's it to be?
Lovely state of affairs, I must say. And you and the army, we'll be living on rice and fish and building railways.
Everything all right, Miss Malone?
Yes.
What are you doing?
Nothing, just checking some signatures. All right, if you must know, I was on the phone and I missed getting the last batch of visitors to sign out.
So you're signing for them? Oh, I don't imagine the governor would be too pleased about that, seeing as how she's told us to tighten security. I mean, an officer forging signatures.
Well, you're not going to tell her, are you? It's not as though I didn't see the people leaving, and I can hardly be everywhere at once.
You saw them leave?
Yes.
Did you count them?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I suppose just this once it can be overlooked. We'll call it our little secret, shall we?
Right. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
I saw Frank today, put on 5 kilograms, and I went out with it.
I still can't believe you're the same Jenny Hartley Pippa used to bring home from school.
Told you it changed. I haven't changed that much.
What about your music? Pippa tells me you're still studying.
Not formally. I play a bit at home, that's all. I was just about to ask Jen for dinner. Is that okay?
Yes, you must.
Oh, I'd love to, but I've stayed too long as it is. I don't want Nana to worry.
Sure.
Thanks anyway. Well, you're going to have to come to dinner one night while I'm home. I'm not taking no for an answer on that. We'll work something out. Great afternoon. Bye, Mrs. Reynolds.
Bye, Jenny. I'm going to have another sherry. What about you?
Ooh, yeah, a small one.
Well, Jenny's certainly grown into a beautiful young woman.
Mm-hmm. Still letting her grandmother walk all over, though.
Yes, well, she does have rather a strong personality, as I recall.
Soft-centered old bat doing her best to wreck Jenny's life, more like it.
Well, surely Jenny's old enough to stand up to her.
Come on, Anne. Haven't you ever heard of emotional blackmail? Just because I have the sense to cut the umbilical cord doesn't mean everyone can. Besides, you're a pussycat compared to old Mrs. Hartley.
Oh, not such a pussycat. I'm going to let you stay here without earning a keep. You can help me with dinner.
What? You'd let a qualified designer peel vegetables? Have you no shame?
No. Hello, Anne Reynolds. Yes, just a moment. International for you.
Thanks. Hello? Oh, hello. Starting to think you'd forgotten me. I'm fine. How's everything over there? Yeah.
Well, I don't know what it is, whether it's the food or just being there in the city itself. But there's something about having breakfast in Paris. Even if it's just croissant and coffee, there's pure magic.
Oh,
what and coffee? Croissant. You know, those little buns that you bake fresh for breakfast?
Oh, yeah. Oh, don't you just love fresh bread? You know, when I was growing up, we lived down the road from a bakery and I'd go mad some nights when the wind was blowing our way.
Hey, yeah, I know what you mean. We used to live next door to a gym where all these boxes and wrestlers would work out and the smell of the sweat and the liniment.
Yeah. Oh, gee, shut up!
Had you really lived in Paris?
For a while. But Annie and I used to fly there in our private jet just to have a meal in one of our most favourite restaurants.
Your own jet plane?
Well, it was quite small.
Oh, boy, I bet you miss it now, eh?
I don't mind. As long as I can keep in contact with Arnie and some of my closer friends. And the phone makes quite sure of that.
I hardly think they'll let you do that, dear. Phone call's a bit of a luxury in here, you know.
Yeah.
That's why I had to insist on a private phone.
What?
A phone?
In your cell?
Great chance you got. Reckon I can still hear them laughing now.
On the contrary, I expect it to be installed immediately.
Are you serious?
Yes. Of course, there's quite a bit of resistance at first, but a little pressure in the right areas soon overcame that.
Won't do you any good. They'll be listening into every word you say.
I realize that. I'm not stupid.
There are ways of phrasing things so that only the right people can understand what you say.
Wow, secret codes, just like in the movies.
Here's Nora.
Oh, how are you, love? All right now?
A lot better than all right.
Hey, what happened to you? You look as though you've been paroled or something.
A lot better than that, too. The one thing I've always wanted, more than anything, for the past 20 years. I finally got myself pregnant.
Nora?
No!
I don't know what they expect me to do. I never committed a real crime in my life. Don't know where to start. I suppose I'm going to spend the rest of my days stuck out here away from my friends. How would you like it? How would you like it if they told you you couldn't see your friends anymore? The person might as well be dead.
How's it going, Granny? You want a chip?
No, Tara, Steffi Savage. Except the seagulls got most of it.
Yeah, I saw that. Hey, you got to keep your strength up. Otherwise, you might be joining your mates down at the funeral park.
It's not a very nice thing to say, is it?
Only so I'm concerned for your health and safety, sweetheart. Got to look after our senior sitch, you know.
You're going to a party.
What do you mean?
You know, fancy dress.
Nah, this is me best. Got a job interview, see?
Get on with it, Phil.
What job are you after?
Brain surgeon.
Oh, go on, you're having me on.
I'm going.
Oh, all right. You just been down the post office, then?
No, why?
Well, isn't that what you old birds get up to? Down the bank, cash the pension check, then off to the bingo?
No, not me, no.
Oh, you saving yours up for a rainy day, eh?
No, money's the least of my problems.
Oh, God, look at that big storm cloud up there.
Sorry, Granny!
Cheeky little bugger!
Just a joke,
I'm
don't.
I'm not the old, but I'm no fool. You're nothing but a little thief. Little thief. You might be the very person I'm looking for.
Get off me. I can't hardly breathe, you old bat.
If you want to make some real money, I think I've got just the deal for you.
I appreciate what you did before. Not saying anything about those signatures. I owe you a favour.
Oh, officers should stick together. A lot of people would like to see us fighting amongst ourselves.
Yes.
Not just the prisoners either. Sometimes the politics in this place make me sick.
I know what you mean. One thing, though. The governor's finally decided to tighten up security. It's got to be a change for the better.
It's as far as it goes.
How do you mean?
The likes of Desmond and Kelly. Can't see it making any difference to them. They'll still find a way to get around the rules as long as they know there's no comeback. You see, the governor's idea of being strict is to put them into solitary for a day or two. They're laughing at us.
Yes, I know. You must be quite angry about the way they tried to frame you.
Quite angry.
If it was me, I can tell you I'd be wanting to pay them back.
As a matter of fact, I have been thinking along those lines. But the governor's expecting it, and she's watching like a hawk. I could still do it, though. Do a proper job on the both of them. Get rid of them once and for all. All I'd need would be the help of another officer.
Say someone was willing to help. Do you have any ideas?
Oh, yes. I have ideas.
What do you say we have a drink tonight, and you can tell me what they are?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, the roses here.